This video is brought to you by Bella Canvas. The innovators behind Black Heather and Fast Fashion just launched their very own YouTube channel. This video is long overdue. What's the difference between Photoshop and Illustrator for t-shirt design? The answer is coming right up. What's up, guys? Gary Agenet here, T-Shirt Help Desk. And I have received so many comments over the years about, number one, like, what program am I using? And I'm like, obvious it's Illustrator or Photoshop. But I realized that a lot of you guys, you know, you don't quite know. You're new, and there are a lot of options out here. Now, me, I rock with Photoshop and Illustrator. I've been doing it for years, and if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Okay, Photoshop and Illustrator are the industry standard, all right? And I'm not messing with it. If you're gonna rock, rock with the best. That's my personal opinion. So that's the only people that I endorse, and the only people that I really design and I use when I do my video. So without any further ado, I am going to show you the difference in case you're confused, you don't know which one to use, depends on your design style and what you're trying to do, the difference between Photoshop and Illustrator and which one may be best for you. All right, want to hit? Here it go. All right, guys, the difference between Photoshop and Illustrator. We're going to start with Photoshop. This is Photoshop, okay? And I have a really great tutorial in which I teach Photoshop. The link is in the description. And I go over this in detail in the tutorial, but I'm just going to go over this briefly here. If you go in and you pull in close, all right? Let's go in, and it's already starting to change. And you go in and you pull in close to this guy, right? In a Photoshop or raster or pixel-based program, you're going to see all these little dots. You see how we went from something that looks like a person's face all the way into these little dots? All right, these are called pixels, okay? Photoshop is based upon pixels, all right? They're little squares of color that come together. See, darkest darks right here, dark, then a little bit lighter, then light for a highlight. And all these little boxes come together to actually make up photographs, okay? All right, it's a digital representation of real life things and made by little dots, which are called pixels. Let's go over here to this guy. Okay, you can see the same thing here, right? It's just little dots. So all these little subtle nuances of shade, okay, when you go and see his beard, it's like really dark right here and then highlight it right here. All right, in order to get that and make it look realistic, you need the little pixels, okay? And the thing about it is that the smaller or the amount of pixels that you have, the more detail you can have. For instance, every square inch right here has a number of pixels. And depending on how many of these dots are in a square inch, okay, gives you the better detail. That's why you always hear something about DPI, dots per inch. That's what that means, okay? So Photoshop is based upon little dots, and those little dots help you make photographs, okay? Hope that makes sense. Let's go over to Illustrator, okay? Now, this right here is a logo made in Illustrator, okay? This, just to let you guys know, plug, this is my new channel that's coming real soon, probably in August, called T-Shirt Design School, in which I'll do nothing but stuff like this, which is teach design. I'm kind of breaking T-Shirt Help Desk up. But we're going to go in close, all right? Let's go in close right over here. And you're going to see that there are no dots, okay? There's no dots here, baby. What this is vector, the other one are pixels, and this are vectors, okay? So in order to make these shapes, okay, you have these dots and these anchor points, okay? And you can play and manipulate them. It's really a mathematical equation, okay? And this gives you the ability to play and manipulate shapes almost like your drawing. Okay, and as a matter of fact, with certain tools, you can actually draw in Illustrator. All right, now I go over that in detail in my Illustrator course. I have a Photoshop course as well. Okay, so this, my friends, gives you the ability to go in and just work your magic, all right, and play with any and all of these shapes, change them around, make them bigger, smaller, go up. You can do all this stuff, and how you actually do this, I go over in detail in the tutorial. But you can also play with and change each individual color, all right? So Illustrator is really very much like drawing. You can play with these shapes, okay? Mathematical equation known as a vector, okay? So that pretty much is the basic difference, all right? And if you do a lot of drawing, if you do a lot of spot prints and things of that nature, and text, definitely text, then Illustrator is for you, because you can take any type of text. Let's just say you type this out. Okay, that's basic text, okay? But then let's just say we change this to that right there, okay? You can take this and create outlines on it and make it a shape, okay? And now you can, just like before, you can have all types of fun. Let's go in closer and play. Okay, you can change the shapes and make them exactly how you want, and of course change the color and all this stuff. Now this is another thing I want to show you. No matter how close you get in, okay, this will always maintain its sharpness, okay, always, because it's vector. Meaning you can take this and you can blow up on the size of the Empire State Building and it will be just as sharp. To whereas in Photoshop, okay, with something like this, you really have to go in and make a really high DPI in order to make, to blow it up. Like something like this, let's say you had like 100 dots per inch. That would look good, or 50 dots per inch, 50, 100. That would look good on like a cell phone or something like that. But if you wanted to put it in like a movie screen or put it up on a billboard, it's going to look terrible. It's going to look just like this. All right, so that's one of the advantages to Illustrator, but it's still, you can still get to be sharp. You just have to use more dots per inch. They're totally different technologies, guys. So I wanted you to see that. Now, just to let you guys know, depending on what type of t-shirts you're going to use, it really can make the difference in which program you should get. So I'm going to go through and show you some different types of t-shirts and different styles and show you which one and which program lends itself to, so it can help you depending on what type of t-shirts you want to do. It can help you make your decision. All right, so I'm going to go in and show that right about now. What's up, guys? Just wanted to have a brief little intermission to let you know that you can get the whole Photoshop, Illustrator, Creative Cloud, whichever ones you want to get. They're on sale now for 60% off. There was a time, a long time ago, when like Photoshop and Illustrator, they were like crazy mad expensive, okay? And I know that that could be a deterrent, but nowadays it's like dirt cheap, okay? It's a few dollars a month, okay? And now it's like 60% off, so it's crazy, all right? So, you can either, if there's a card up there, check out that card, and if not, go right into the description box. The first couple of links will take you to get Illustrator, Photoshop, Creative Cloud for 60% off. Can't beat that with a stickball bat, all right? I'ma holla. Let's get back to the video. Okay, guys, so now let's get into some styles, okay? Some simple styles, all right? Let's get rid of this. Okay, so we have some Photoshop styles and we have some Illustrator styles, okay? So, right here, now don't go by the blank. Just look at this artwork. This is one color. It's just a drawing of this tiger, lion type thing, knives, and some words. This is perfect for Illustrator, okay? Here, you have boxes. It's just boxes. and some type. Okay, you have some, looks like some Asian or Japanese type, some letters, and some old English letters. Okay, you have this right here, which is like a shape, some Japanese letters, a circle, some more Japanese letters, and some English. I mean, really simple spot prints. This is nothing but white and red. Okay, and you have something like this, a few more colors, but this is kind of like a comic book looking thing. But if you look at it, it's just red, black, yellow, blue, and white. You know, very, very simple. Very, very simple. This could be done in Illustrator very simply. Okay, look at this one right here. Okay, really cool T-shirt. But if we're gonna go in closer a little bit, and if you look at this, you're gonna see that it's just like it's white, gray, yellow, and that light yellow and the black outline, and that's it for everything. And they got red, the pink, or the light red, and this one is like a tan or a brown and a darker tan, or a lighter tan rather. It's, you can see that it's really simple. There's not a lot of grading, there's not a lot of going back and forth of this little pixels that you would need to go from light to dark. It's very spot on, spot color. These can be done with a screen printing machine. Very, very easy. Okay, look at this one. Okay, with the mouth. Okay, this is pretty much, I mean, you have pink, white, black outline, and a little bit of gray, and that's it. I mean, can you see that this is really graphic, big, bold graphic, and it's not really photographic, all right? So if you look through these, you can see, like, look at this one. I showed you this before. This one is a play off of Gucci Mane's tattoo. You know, it's black, red, blue, pink, yellow, and that tan. And you see there's not any, it's just a flat color. These are all flat color, no gradation. These are all perfect for Illustrator. All right. This one too, you know, all just spot flat colors. Okay. You can see this one. These are just spot flat colors. You see this? Black, white, yellow skin, a little bit of gray right here, and it's done. Okay, so let's go over here to some of these Photoshop tees. This is, I believe, Cassie, and you can see that this is a real, live, actual photo, Photoshop. You get it? And you can see there's a lot of like gradation of going in to get to capture the skin tones to make. Although this is, you know, black and white with a little bit of blue. There's a lot of gradation going on, okay, from darks and lights to get those highlights to make it look realistic. You know what I'm saying? Like that other stuff, that does not look real. That looks like a cartoon. This right here is a photograph. You got the lion, okay, this is perfect, and you got the gradation, the blue going all the way up, perfect for Photoshop. This is another photograph, Estevan Oreo photograph, okay, this, you know, perfect for Photoshop. Okay, look at this pink dolphin shirt. Let's blow this one up. Okay, you can see that if we go in closer, you can see that it's a pink dolphin. You can see it's got like light pinks, dark pinks, there's kind of a light pink to a white highlight, all this color, all these little color. This is Photoshop. This is perfect for Photoshop, photographic graded. I hope this is making sense. So if you want to do t-shirts that look like this, learn Illustrator. If you want to do t-shirts that look like this, or use Photoshop, or use photos, learn Photoshop. The best thing is to have them both. Like me, I know them both very well, and I teach them. And you can get my courses. Go to the link below in the description box. Get my Illustrator courses. I teach you from the rooter to the tutor. But let's go right here. Look at this one, okay? You see, if we go in closer, man, like this one is like, it's got like the Super Bowl trophy. It's got like some women with the little booties out or whatever. It's got money. It's got roses, diamonds. I mean, there's a lot going on right here, and it all looks photographic. There's a lot of gradation. See the orange to the yellows, skin tones, roses. This, my friends, is probably one, I'm 99.9% sure was done in Photoshop. Anything that looks photorealistic, all right, or with a lot of, even if it's art, if it has a lot of gradation, okay, gradients going from lights to dark, a whole lot of, you know, like this is going from dark orange to yellow, orange, blues to this white down here. That's Photoshop, guys. All right. So I hope this is making sense to you guys. I hope this is making, look at this. This one is black and white again, and you can see it's like, you know, it's like an astronaut's helmet, but this is the ground color, but it goes all the way up, and it's a whole lot of gray, and it looks like a real life photograph. Photoshop, guys. Photoshop, Illustrator. Okay, now you can, now don't just think that you can just do simple stuff in Illustrator. You can do some really great more complicated stuff too, like this with all the little paint splatter and stuff. All that could be done in Illustrator. Okay, something like this with this gradation. Okay, you can actually gradate, and I should teach you how you can do this simple gradation in Photoshop. Okay, let's go something like this. All right, this spaceman thing. Okay, this can actually be, I'm sorry, this one right here could be done in Illustrator. This gradation could be done in Illustrator. Okay, this right here, okay, you can do this in Illustrator. Okay, you see it's a little bit, it's not as much gradations, a little bit more, it's kind of spot color. You can do more complicated stuff. It's just that Photoshop lends itself to gradation and going from light colors to dark colors and all that stuff. So I hope this makes sense. You know, stuff like this, perfect for Illustrator. Okay, simple, you know, stuff that looks like it was drawn, you know, a lot of spot colors and stuff that has a lot of gradients and gradations, like this, it lends itself to Photoshop. Okay, and I teach all of this stuff from the Ritter to the Photoshop and Illustrator basic and advanced. Okay, so that is it, and I will see you guys on the other side. I hope I kind of explained this, and I hope it makes sense. All right, until next time, ladies and gentlemen, peace. All right, guys, that was the Illustrator versus Photoshop t-shirt design video. Hope you enjoyed it. Now, if you like stuff like this, Bella Canvas has launched their own YouTube channel. All right, you go right up there. There should be a card, or you can go right in the description box. It'll say, okay. And they launched a new YouTube channel, and they go everything from design inspiration, business tips, behind the scenes, and they are awesome. Okay, if you like t-shirt help desk, if you like this channel, you will love, and I do mean love, Bella Canvas's new YouTube channel. All right, so check that out. Also, Illustrator, 60% off for Creative Cloud, Photoshop, Illustrator, whatever you want. All right, that's down in the description box. All right, listen, remember where you heard it all first. All right, cheers to your t-shirts. I am out. Remember, do something good for somebody, and if not, can't find someone to do something good for, do something good for yourself. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, peace.